神神楽。
Yo, what's up, place called? Welcome back to the channel, XP Kage. Back to you guys, another video. And I know it's been a minute since I uploaded a video or a minute for the anime stuff. For the case, I've lost like 10 subs and gained like 3 more because I've been doing nothing but Fortnite stuff. But it's time to get back into anime stuff. I know it's been a minute since I uploaded a video as well, minus the stream last night. But, or the other night, whenever this video is posted. But there is a reason for that. And it is the 7 Deadly Sins. Yes, I have watched the 7 Deadly Sins. And I was binging that for the longest. And nonetheless, it was a great anime and a roller coaster of an anime as well. Some parts were confusing, but nonetheless, it was overall a great anime. I'm sad that I already finished it. Only 4 seasons, I was hoping it would be longer, but, you know, ended where it needed to end, and ended the way, you know, that I like the ending, is what I'm trying to say. So, beyond this point, this is spoilers, so if you guys don't want to, listen to any spoilers, you know, just ignore the video, or click off the video, come back, watch it. This is over my overall review of the 7 Deadly Sins, and whether if you guys should give it a try or not if you have not watched it at all. So, 7 Deadly Sins, the main character is Meliodas. He is the former leader of the 10 Commandments, the Demon King's son, and the leader of the 7 Deadly Sins, the Dragon Sin, the Sin of Wrath, Meliodas. And he may have the appearance of a young boy, but he is thousands and thousands and thousands of years old. So, the show is basically about him trying to break the curse of Elizabeth. So basically, the goddess, she was the daughter of the divine deity, him being the son of the demon king. They had a love that the divine deity and the demon king did not like, so they placed a curse on them. His curse being eternal life, but each time he dies and comes back, he loses parts of his emotion. And then her being infinite reincarnation. So with her infinite reincarnation, when she reincarnated, she has no memories of her past life. And if she gains memory of her past life, she would die within 3 days' time. And yeah. So he is destined to watch her die over and over again. They're always destined to meet each other and fall in love with each other as well. So yeah, that's, you know, interesting. But anyways, so it's about him trying to break the curse with the 7 Deadly Sins. At first, she tries to find him, and they try to take back the kingdom of Leonis, because it's basically overrun by holy knights, and it's not. And based the entire time, it was a guy named Hendrickson with Dreyfus, possessed by a demon, one of the 10 Commandments. So yeah, that's that. She goes to try to find them. They, you know, find the 7 Deadly Sins with the Serpent Sin, Deanne, the Pride Sin, Escanor, the Fox Sin, the Sin of Greed, Vaughn, the Fairy King, the Sin of, I forget what the sin he was. I think he was I don't remember, actually. The Sin of Lust, Gother, the Goat Sin. I really forget what Sin King was. They didn't really see his sin all that much. But, you know, there's Hawk, the pig. You know, it was a very interesting anime. I really did enjoy it. Not to mention the end of it, where they defeated the Demon King twice to find out Merlin put the curse back on Elizabeth. So they would fight the Demon King so she can reincarnate Chaos. That was a whole roller coaster. And then, you know, they ended up having a son. So basically the theme of the anime is, like I said, they go get the 7 Deadly Sins together. They take back the kingdom. The Holy Knights stand up against Dreyfus and Hendrickson. they defeat them. They go up against the Ten Commandments. They fight the Ten Commandments. They sort of beat the Ten Commandments. They go up against the Demon King, win against the Demon King, go up against the Demon King again, win against the Demon King again. Go up against a Chaos Beast. They defeat that. They defeat him. And yeah, I basically summed up the whole anime. But you know, they him and Elizabeth, they break the curse. Him and Elizabeth get the they get married. He becomes the king. She becomes the queen. They have a son named Tristan. Apparently, Tristan did not know anything about the Seven Deadly Sins and thought his father was a part of a evil organization of the Seven Deadly Sins. Gother gives him a gift for his 10th birthday, which is the Seven Deadly Sins entirely. He puts in his head the memories and the journeys of the Seven Deadly Sins, which wraps up the whole series, which is overall a really, really great ending. Like I said, I really did love the ending. It was just amazing. And then you see Vaughn and Elaine have their kid. You know, each one of them had their own individual mission. The Fairy King's mission, of course, going back to the Fairy King's forest. I forget what Deanne's goal was, but Merlin's goal was to revive Chaos. Elizabeth's goal was to, well, bring peace to the kingdom. Meliodas' goal was to break Elizabeth's curse. They all had their own individual goals. Bond was to bring Elaine back to life, and they all mostly succeeded in their goals, with King officially reawakening his, awakening his true Fairy King powers, and with him and Deanne, you know, getting together and getting married eventually as well, with Elaine and Vaughn getting married. I'm pretty sure they're married as well, and with have a kid. You know, it was a really happy ending. Everyone had an happy ending but Escanor. I didn't think I liked Escanor too much until his death. That dude was a really good Sin. You know, it was unfortunate that Escanor had to die. There was many times I thought Gother was gone. That didn't happen. And sometimes where I thought King or Deanne was gonna die, which I'm happy that either of them did, because I was wanting them to get together. But Escanor had a big crush on Merlin, so he definitely loved Merlin, and Merlin kissed him in the end, keeping his burns as a momentum, you know, a tribute to him. But yeah, Escanor used the last of his power, Sunshine, which was given to him by one of the four archangels. I forget his name. It was like Mael, one of the four archangels, Mael, which his mind was warped by the original Gother that wasn't the doll, in order to make him think that he was one of the seven deadly, well, one of the Ten Commandments and the brother of Meliodas and Zeldris. But like overall and all, I think there was a perfect anime, 10 out of 10. I really enjoyed the anime and it was really great. If you guys wanna, you know, check it out, feel free to check it out. You know, I advise you guys go check out this anime if you have not watched it yet. It is really good. I'm about to go watch the movie soon, and then I'm finna watch those other four episodes of Seven Deadly Sins, the beginnings of the Holy War. I don't know if that ties in anything or not, but that's the end of the video. Peace out, Plague Squad, XBKage out.